Welcome back, programmers. As you know, in the previous video, we just created the Hello World web application using the WorkZook. Now, if you missed the previous two video, link is in the description. Check out now. So in the previous video, we just created the class AOC first and simply created a few functions for initialize the Redis host server and the port, sending the response in the text format, as you can see, just like this, and create the last function to create an default app using the local host Redis host server with the static files. So this is the static file code. If you miss this code, you will not be able to get the static files container in your front end. And in the last, we just used the if main equal to main. We are going to run this create app function. So that is it. This is how we created the Hello World function, or first WorkZook application web program. So in the today's section, we are going to move on. So the basic idea here is that our AOC first class is an actual WSGI application. The call method directly dispatches to the WSGI app. This is done so that we can wrap WSGI app to apply middleware like we do in the create app function. The actually WSGI app method then create a request object and call the dispatch request method, which then has to return a response object, which is the then evaluated as the WSGI application again. As you can see, turtles all the way down both the AOC first class we created as well as any request object in WorkZook implementation, the WSGI interface. As a result of that, you could even return another WSGI application from the dispatch request method. Now the AOC first factory function can be used to create a new instance of an OR application. Not only will it pass some parameters as configuration to the application, but also optionally add an WSGI middleware that exports static files. This way we have access to this file from the static folder even when we are not configuring our server to provide them, which is very helpful for our development. So now let's move on. So now we are going to run the application. Now you should be able to execute the file Python and C server on your local machine. We just saw Hello World. It also tells you that Reloader is active. It will use various techniques to figure out if any file changed on the disk and then automatically restart. Just go to the URL and you should see Hello World, just like this Hello World. Now step 3, the environment. Now that we have the basic application class, we can take the constructor, do something useful and provide a few helpers on there that can come in handy. We will need to be able to render the templates and connect to Redis, so let's extend the class a bit. And for that, in initialize part, in init method in constructor, we are going to change something to render the templates. First of all, we are going to add the template path. So just write create a variable templates path equal to os.path.join os.path.directory name file underscore underscore file templates. So now that we got the template path, we can use our template folder in here. Now remember, in here you just have to add the whatever folder you created for the template. In our case, as you can see, we created the templates. Now that we created the template, we have to create the Jinja. Now if you don't know what is Jinja, Jinja is a web template engine for the Python programming language. It was created by Armin Roncher and is licensed under BSD license. Jinja is similar to the Django template engine but provides Python-like experience while ensuring that the templates are evaluating as the sandbox. Now if you wanna learn more about Jinja, check out my every Django series, you will understand it more. Now that we created this template path, in our init method, we have to create the self.jinja.env, which is nothing but the jinja.env variable for our class, which we can use to create a template. So in a simple way, just write self.jinja.env, which is nothing but our variable name, equal to environment. Now what is this environment? This is nothing but from Jinja to import environment and file system loader. So this is that environment from Jinja to Now Jinja 2 is nothing but programming language kind of for web developers, and we can use this Jinja 2 environment to create an or own Jinja 2 environment. So with the use of this environment function, we can use it to create an environment for our template. So simply just pass the loader equal to file system loader, which is going to load our file, which is nothing but this template file, and we just gotta pass the path of that particular template, so which is nothing but this template path. So let's use this. So loader equal to file system loader and pass the template path, and auto escape equal to true. This is simple as hell. Okay, so as you can see, we just created the Jinja 2 environment, and we just passed the template path, which is nothing but this path templates. Okay, so now what we are going to do, we are going to render this template, and we are going to create an HTML file in this template, and we are going to return the render of that particular HTML file. So let's create a function. You can name it anything. I'm going to name it render template. We'll take two main arguments, which is nothing but the template names and the context, which is context is nothing but the context for whatever context we are going to return. For example, if you know Django, in Django we return some variables or some data from backend to frontend, and that's called the context. So in here I'm going to create a variable named t. You can name it anything. Now in this t we are going to get the environment template, which is nothing but the self.jinja.env. Now jinja.env is nothing but the this self.jinja.env, which we are going to use it in here. Dot get template, which is nothing but the whatever template we are loading in here, we are going to get it in here, and we are going to just pass the template name. Now where we are going to pass this template name? In later we are going to pass this template name whenever we use this render template, and we are simply gonna just pass this template name. Now we use the double star context, which is nothing but the multiple argument. If you don't know what is double star context, it means we are going to pass some arguments with the keys and the values, or you can say with the dictionary format. If you wanna pass the multiple dictionary format argument, so you can use the double star and whatever variable name. So in simple way, we are going to pass the dictionary value in here, and then simply just return the response t.render. Now we are going to use the render function using the t, which is nothing but the object of Jinja.env, and simply pass the context, which is nothing but the whatever context you are passing. If you don't have any context, it's okay, but if you have any context, it will pass automatically from here. And mime type equal to text slash html, because I don't know what text will be, because sometime it will be text, sometime it will be html, so it will get both. Okay, now that we created the render template, in the next step we are going to create a url configuration. So next up is routing. Routing is the process of matching and passing the URL to something we can use. WorkZook provide a flexible integrated routing system, which we can use for what? Simply routing. The way it works is that you create a map instance and add a bunch of rules objects. Each rule has pattern. It will try to match the URL against and an endpoint. The endpoint is typically a string and can be used to uniquely identify the URL. We could also use this to automatically reverse the URL, but that's not what we will do in this tutorial. Now if you know Django, you know urls.py file, we create the URL for particular path. For example, Amazon. In Amazon, let's say in homepage, the main homepage is whatever domain name, and slash, let's say you choose the mobile, let's say iPhone. So slash iPhone is another URL for that particular category product. And that's why we use the URL configuration to specify this perfect URL. So in the constructor, in the init file, we are going to pass this URL, which is nothing but the self.urlmap equal to. Now where is self.urlmap? Which is nothing but the URL map variable. Now as you can see from workzook.routing import map and rule. So this map will help us to create a URL routing, and for that just import the from workzook.routing import map. Now this map provide us a lots of functionality to create a URL. For example, in here, as you can see, we just created the variable self.url map equal to map, which is nothing but the inbuilt function. So just pass the list of that particular URL which you wanna go. For example, in here, the first rule is nothing but create a new URL. So just pass the RULE, R is capital, and create a tuple. And the first parameter is the string format URL name. So in here you have to pass the URL name. For example, because you are in the home page, you can just pass the slash. But let's say if you want to create a new URL, let's say product. So in here just pass the product and then slash. It will run, and endpoint equal to where you wanna redirect to that particular URL. Now the second one is the less than and greater than short ID. Now in here we can pass the ID. For example, let's say I wanna send this hello world to the next URL. So what I can do, I can copy this URL and store it in that particular variable and send it to that particular ID which I am creating in here, for example short ID. So it will store it in here, short ID, and we can use this short ID in this particular URL. That's why we create the ID URL, or you can say it variable, because this is the variable for URL and we can store anything in here. And endpoint equal to whatever link you wanna send in here. In Django we use the function path in here, but in here we use the endpoint. In a simple way, here we create a URL map with the three rules: slash for the root of the URL space, where we will just dispatch to a function that implement to logic to create a new URL, and then one that follows that short link to the target URL, and add another one with the same rule but plus at the end to show the link details. So how do we find our way from the endpoint to a function? That's up to you. The way we will do it in our tutorial is by calling the method on underscore plus endpoint on the class itself. Here it how this work. So in the dispatch request function, we are going to add these lines for URL endpoints. So in the previous we were returning the response, but this time we are going to catch the URL and endpoint. But this is the next part. In the next part, we are going to learn more about the URL and URL endpoints and how we can use the URL to redirect the one page from another, and how we can use the endpoint and the values, and how we are going to create our first views. Now, if you don't know what is view, view is nothing but our logic where we are going to send and request the data. So that is it for today's guys. In the next video, we are going to learn about URL and views. Now, if you missed all of my previous video, so link is in the description. And if you don't wanna miss our next part, please hit on the bell icon so you'll never miss my latest video. See you guys in the next video. Till then, just code.